One of the biggest and most costly mistakes embedded developers make is they do all their development on a PC and at the last minute push it to the device and see if it works. With Qt for embedded device creation, that's a thing of the past. You can develop right in an emulator even if you don't have the hardware. It's recommended you fully test on the hardware before you deploy, but if you don't have the hardware readily available, you can work in the emulator. Let's go ahead and run this and debug it right on the device. We're going to flip to our code. And as you can see, on line 58, we have a breakpoint. Let's go ahead and debug this. Bring up our emulator and wait for the program to load. Let's click some buttons and see what happens. Start, stop, bam. We're actually debugging right on the device. That is pretty cool. We can even look at the object inspector and see exactly what's going on in the code on the device itself. There's zero guesswork as to what's going on here. Let's go ahead and stop debugging and start the Clang static analyzer. Let's run this, and just to verify, there is nothing wrong with our code. Just wanted to double check just in case. Let's go ahead and inspect the CPU usage just to see what it looks like. Let's go ahead and run our application. Click start, stop, reset, goal, and let's switch around. Let's stop our application and wait for the analyzer to finish. This is extremely cool. You can deeply inspect and see exactly what's going on that device. You can see our integration and you can flow through a timeline. You can also look at a flame graph and see the statistics. That is just simply amazing if you're an embedded developer. We can also very easily switch from our device to our local and back and forth. Here, we're just simply going to switch to our desktop and go into debug mode. We're going to do memcheck and let's run this. Once memory check is run, we can play around with our application and see where it starts having issues. Let's change our filter and see there are some external errors, but nothing actually in our application itself. That's a good sign. Let's flip this over into release mode. In here, we're going to use call grind. Let's go ahead and run this. Okay, we can start, stop. Our application's working as expected. Let's go ahead and kill this and see exactly what was going on. In here, you can see the number of calls and sort by calls. You can see that's got a lot of calls to it. This is extremely helpful information if you're doing some deep diving into your application. You want to know exactly what is going on under the hood. One of the more challenging questions we get is, why is my code slow on the device? An easy way to find out is simply go into the device, go into profile mode, and then go to your QML profiler. Let's enable profiling and let's run it. As you can see, we're profiling the application in real time. We're going to start, stop, reset, hit our goal, go slowest, fastest. Let's take a look at the results. Let's flip back and let's stop profiling. We get a vast amount of information. You can see that creating is our biggest event at 368 milliseconds. Memory usage stays nice and stable throughout the lifecycle of the application, and we can see our input events. We also get a nice flame graph. And we can change our visualization. For example, here's memory, here's our allocations, and we get our statistics. If you're doing embedded device programming, there's simply nothing else out there as powerful and flexible as Qt for device creation. If you're like me, you're hungry for more. Visit Qt.io, click on resources, then go to development, tech talks, and tutorials. As you can see, we have got a ton of tutorials out there. Go ahead and visit today and let us know what you think. I'll see you there.